There are a ton of free and paid to-do list apps out there, but if you're wondering which one is right for you, don't worry, I've got you covered. These are the best to-do list apps of 2023. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. I've tested a bunch of to-do list apps for you and looked at reviews and tested the features and figured out their ease of use. So I've narrowed it down to a top 8. Let's go. All right, we're gonna run through these apps in alphabetical order, and keep in mind as we go through this list, some of these apps are free and some of these apps are paid. And new to the best to-do list app roundup this year is Akiflow. I want you to think of Akiflow as your ultimate time blocking tool. Akiflow allows you to consolidate all of your tools and apps in one place. So you can bring in tasks from Gmail, Trello, Google Meet, Google Calendar, Notion, Asana, Todoist, and more. This is really handy if you or your team use more than one tool. You can now bring in those individual tasks and take care of them in one central place. Akiflow easily allows for calendar time blocking, and you can easily share your availability and set daily rituals to help make your day planning even easier. Plus, they have a built-in focus mode to help you focus on the task at hand. Now, all of this doesn't come cheap. Akiflow does have a free trial, but after that, it's $15 a month, which is pretty steep. Number 2 on my alphabetical list is Amazing Marvin. This app allows you to completely customize your entire to-do list experience. Their whole purpose is for you to find a workflow that works best for you. And your workflow might be different than my workflow. And they've really leaned into that by incorporating principles from behavioral psychology to help you stay on track. So you can choose from workflow templates, all based on different productivity methods. And of course, you can import and set up your already existing apps and tools like Todoist, TickTick, To-Do, and so on. You can also create nested categories and projects, set deadlines, assign tasks and to-dos, add recurring tasks, set goals, track time, plan your week, add notes, send emails to Marvin to create tasks, and so much more. It's wild everything you can do. Or I guess you could say it's amazing. Get it? So yes, Amazing Marvin is a to-do list app, but it's also a pretty robust productivity app in general. So they have a 30-day free trial, and then you can either pay $8 a month, or you can pay a one-time fee of $300 and have access to Marvin for life. So definitely try it before you buy it and see if it makes sense for you. And with that, let's move on to Any.do. This app provides a calendar and to-do list in one. With Any.do, you can connect your calendar to the app in order to get a snapshot of your calendar events and your to-dos for the day. Plus, it works seamlessly across your devices with its mobile and desktop apps. You can make lists in Any.do and check things off as you complete your tasks, or you could share your lists as well, which is really handy. The best part of Any.do is that it is completely free. Now you can upgrade to the premium version, say if you want like advanced reminders or custom themes, but honestly, the free version is so great and simple with an easy to use interface. All right, we are moving on to one of my favorite to-do list apps, Google Tasks. I've talked a lot about Google Tasks before, so you can watch more Google Tasks videos by clicking up here or via the links in the description below if you want more than just a quick overview. If you live in Gmail and Google Workspace like I do, then look no further than Google Tasks. Google Tasks is a free, simplistic task manager that is found within your suite of Google apps. So there's a mobile app for Google Tasks, but there is no dedicated web app. Instead, Tasks is found within your suite of Google apps in the side panel on the right-hand side of your Gmail or Drive or Calendar. It's linked to your Google account. You can easily create lists and add and organize tasks, and then these lists and tasks will be synced across your web and mobile devices. Plus, if you have more than one Google account, you can easily toggle between them in the Google Tasks mobile app. All right, up next on my list of top to-do list apps is Microsoft To-Do. This is a classic app that is much loved by its user base. Microsoft bought Wunderlist back in 2015 and then built out Microsoft To-Do as a replacement app. While it doesn't have all of the bells and whistles that Wunderlist had, it's really simple to use. If you have a Microsoft account, you can sync up with your other Microsoft apps. And with Microsoft To-Do, you can change themes, create your to-do lists, share those lists with others, and create recurring tasks. And the best part, you know it's coming, Microsoft To-Do is completely free. Another great to-do list app is Routine. Routine is not only a souped-up calendar app, but it's a great place to centralize all of your tasks. Routine is, what can I say, a pretty app. And by that I mean both the user interface and the design are honestly superb. So Routine combines your calendar, tasks, and notes into a well-laid out and organized central spot. Routine kind of acts like a cross between like Akiflow and Sunsama, but I really like the interface of Routine. It even has a natural language-based console where you can input commands in a fraction of the time. Yes, please, AI integration. But if you have Fantastical, as an example, which is an app I featured in my Best Free Mac Apps of 2023 video, you might be familiar with natural language prompts. And that's really what we're doing here with Routine. So basically, the console lets you quickly create tasks and events with a simple prompt, and then those will automatically be added to your calendar for you, without you having to manually add the event or task to your calendar or manually block out time for that. But it also lets you schedule and reschedule tasks in the same way. Currently, in order to access Routine, you will need to request access to their free tier. They are working on a paid professional tier, but that's not available, at least as of the recording of this video. All right, I think we are on to-do list app number 7, and in this slot is TickTick. I actually love TickTick so much that it has made a few different lists before, so I've linked to those videos in the description below as well. TickTick is a powerful yet easy to use task manager. TickTick works across platforms, so you can stay organized from mobile to web. But my favorite part about TickTick, besides the awesome name, of course, is the ability to add tasks quickly via keyboard shortcuts. So Command Shift A or Control Shift A on Windows will allow you to quickly add a task from any screen. You can also share your tasks with others. Like I said, TickTick is completely free. And now we've come to the part of the video where I kindly ask you, if you are enjoying this video, to please remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. And now back to the list. It wouldn't be a best to-do list apps of 2023 without mentioning Todoist. A solid one indeed. Todoist remains one of the best rated to-do list apps on the market for a number of reasons. It has a great user interface, it's easy to use, and it works offline. You can quickly add tasks, recurring due dates, and create sections and subtasks. Plus, you can also set priority levels for your tasks, highlighting the most important ones you want to get through in a day. You can delegate tasks to team members as well as customize your own task views through themes and different boards. Now, of course, Todoist connects with your email and calendars as well. There is a free version where you can create up to 5 projects and have 5 collaborators per project, but you don't get the custom themes or backups with that. It is a good place to start though, so that you can get an idea if you like the user interface and overall function of the app. Now the pricing tier goes up from there. It's between $3 to $5 per month for pro and business users, which honestly is pretty affordable. Phew, we've made it. Remember, there are links to all of these apps in the description below, as well as links to additional video content. You know I've got you. So those are my picks for the best to-do list apps of 2023. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite to-do list apps and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more content. What's one more video? Go on, do it. Thanks for watching. See you next time.